Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the topic Internal Combustion Engine. And this is lecture number 16. We are going to solve few problems in the IC engines from Anna University question paper. And in the earlier lecture also, we solved problems. So lecture number 14 and 15 we solved problems. We have additional problems from Anna University question paper. So we are going to solve few more problems in Anna University question paper. So learning outcome for the students at the end of the lecture, the student will solve the problem in IC engines. This is problem number 9 from Anna University question paper May 2009. Fuel supplied to an SI engine has a calorific value of 42,000 kilojoules per kilogram. The pressure in the cylinder at 30% and 70% of the compression stroke are 1.3 bar and 2.6 bar respectively. Assuming that the compression follows the law PV to the power 1.3 equal to constant, find the compression ratio. If the relative efficiency of the engine compared with the air standard efficiency is 50%, calculate the fuel consumption in kilogram per kilowatt hour. And the given data, calorific value is 42,000 kilojoules per kilogram. Polytropic index N equal to 1.3 and relative efficiency is 0.5. And the PV diagram for the compression process is shown here. So, V1 is the beginning of the compression. V2 is the end of the compression. So, we are given 30% of the compression stroke. That is 30% is V1 dash. And 70% of the compression stroke V2 dash. At V1 dash the pressure is 1.3 bar. At V2 dash the pressure is 2.6 bar. Now the compression begins here V1 and ends here V2. So V2 is 100% of the compression stroke. So V2 equal to 100% of the stroke volume or the compression volume. So which is considered as 1. Now V1 dash, we measure V1 dash from V2. So V2 up to this volume, so V2 plus the length between V2 and V1 dash is 0.7 times of V1 minus V2. So the length between V1 dash and V2 is 0.7 times of V1 minus V2. So we take V2 outside, so V2 into 1 plus 0.7 into V1 by V2 minus 1. And this V2, as we told, it is 1. So V1 by V2 equal to R. So, V1 dash equal to 1 plus 0.7 into R minus 1 and you will write this as 0.7R plus 0.3. Similarly, V2 dash equal to measuring from here V2 plus 0.3, 30% of V1 minus V2 which is V2 into, so we take V2 outside as usual, so plus 1 plus 0.3 times of V1 by V2 minus 1. Now again V2 equal to 1, so this becomes V2 dash becomes 1 plus 0.3 into R minus 1 which is 0.3 R plus 0.7. Now we calculate the ratio. To calculate the compression ratio, we take V1 dash by V2 dash. V1 dash by V2 dash equal to P2 dash by P1 dash to the power 1 by 1.3. So V1 dash equal to 0.7 R plus 0.3 and V2 dash equal to 0.3 R plus 0.7. So, P2 by P1 equal to 2.6 divided by 1.3 to the power 1.3, 1 by 1.3 equal to 1.704. Now, this value 0.7R plus 0.3 divided by 0.3R plus 0.7 equal to 1.1704. So, solving cross multiplying 0.7R plus 0.3 equal to 1.704 into 0.3R plus 0.7. So, solving this equation, we will get R equal to 4.72. So, the compression ratio is 4.72. So, it is very simple calculation. So, we can calculate, rearrange the terms, simple arithmetic calculation, R equal to compression ratio equal to 4.72. Now, we calculate the air standard efficiency, eta A equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power N minus 1. So, the compression follows the law, PV to the power N equal to constant. So, 1 minus 1 by 4.72 to the power 0.3. So, this is 0.372 equal to 37.2%. And we calculate the indicated thermal efficiency. We are given relative efficiency is 0.5. So indicated thermal efficiency equal to 0.5 into 0.372, so which is 0.186, which is 18.6%. So indicated thermal efficiency is 18.6%. Then the fuel consumption per kilowatt hour. So from the definition of indicated thermal efficiency, IP by MF into CV, so which is 1 by MF by IP. So IP is taken to the denominator, MF by IP into CV. So this mass of fuel per kilowatt of indicator power is indicated specific fuel consumption, ISFC into CV. So ISFC equal to 1 by indicator thermal efficiency into calorific value. So 3600 to convert into kilogram per hour, 3600 will be 0.186 into 42,000 equal to 0.461 kilogram per kilowatt hour. So the fuel consumption per kilowatt hour equal to 0.461 kilograms per kilowatt hour. So the answer to the problem, combustion ratio equal to 4.72, fuel consumption per kilowatt hour equal to 0.461 kilogram per kilowatt hour. So we take the next problem. Example number 10 from November 2012 question paper. The bore and stroke of a water cooled vertical single cylinder 4 stroke diesel engine are 80 mm and 110 mm respectively. And the torque is 23.5 Newton meter. So calculate the mean effective pressure of the engine. So we are given diameter equal to 0.08 meter, stroke length equal to 0.11 meter and the work done torque equal to 23.5 Newton meter. So we calculate the swept volume or the stroke volume. So Vs equal to pi by 4 d square into L, which is pi by 4 into 0.08 square into 0.11 equal to 5.5264 in 10 power minus 4 meter cube. And the mean effective pressure is work done divided by the swept volume. So 23.5 divided by 5.5264 into 10 power minus 4 divided by 1000 to convert into Newton meter. So it is 42.52 kilonewton meter square and the mean effective pressure is 42.52 kilopascal. The next problem, example number 11 from May 2013 question paper. A 4 cylinder 4 stroke diesel engine has a bore of 212 millimeter and the stroke of 292 millimeter. At full load at 720 rpm, the brake mean effective pressure BMEP is 5.93 bar. And the specific fuel consumption is 0.226 kilogram per kilowatt hour. The air fuel ratio as determined by the exhaust gas analysis is 25. Calculate the brake thermal efficiency, volumetric efficiency of the engine. The atmospheric conditions are 1.01 bar and 15 degrees Celsius. And the calorific value of the fuel may be taken as 44,200 kilojoules per kilogram. So the given data are diameter D equal to 0.212 meter, stroke length equal to 0.292 meter. Speed N equal to 720 rpm and the brake mean effective pressure is 5.93 bar. Specific fuel consumption SFC equal to 0.226 kilogram per kilowatt hour. Air fuel ratio is 25. Pressure P1 equal to 1.01 bar. Temperature T1 equal to 15 degrees Celsius, which is 288 Kelvin. It is a 4 cylinder 4 stroke engine with the calorific value 44,200. Now the brake power. So brake power equal to brake mean effective pressure into pi by 4 D square into L. N divided by 2 into K. So, N divided by 2, N is speed divided by 2. So, there are in a 4 stroke cycle engine for 2 revolutions of the crankshaft, there will be 1 explosion. So, N by 2, that is the meaning, N by 2 into K is the number of cylinder. So, substitute numerical value is 5.93 into 100 into pi by 4 into 0.212 square into 0.292, 720 rpm divided by 2 into 60. So, this 60 to convert the speed into RPS into 4. So, this is 146.6 kilowatts. So, the brake power is 146.6 kilowatts. Then the brake thermal efficiency. So, we are given BP by brake thermal efficiency is brake power divided by mass of the fuel into calorific value, heat supplied. So, I take the brake power to the denominator 1 by MF by BP into CV. So, this is 3600 divided by SFC. So, SFC is the specific fuel consumption. So, 3600 divided by 0.226 into 44,200. Into 100 equal to 36.03%. Then density of the air for the intake conditions. So rho equal to P by RT. So 101 kilopascal divided by 0.287 into 288 equal to 1.22 kilograms per meter cube. And theoretical mass of the air. So we have mass of the air equal to density into volume of the air taken during the suction stroke. So rho into pi by 4 into d square into L into n by 120. Again, there is only one suction stroke in every two revolutions of the crankshaft. So n by 120 into k. So 1.22 into pi by 4 into 0.212 square into 0.292 into 720 divided by 120 into 4. This is 0.30 kilograms per second. And mass of the fuel equal to MF equal to BP into SFC. So 146.6 into 0.226 divided by 3600 equal to 9.2 into 10 power minus 3 kilograms per second. And mass of the actual mass of the air equal to mass of the fuel into air fuel ratio. So 9.2 into 10 power minus 3 into 25 equal to 0.23 kilograms per second. Now the volumetric efficiency is mass of the air, actual mass of the air divided by theoretical mass of the air. So 0.23 divided by 0.3 into 100 equal to 76.7%. So the answer to the problem, brake thermal efficiency is 36.03% and volumetric efficiency is 76.7%. The example number 12 from November 2013 question paper. The following data are available for a 4-stroke petrol engine. Air fuel ratio by weight 15.5:1. Calorific value of the fuel 45,000 kilojoules per kilogram. Mechanical efficiency 81%. Air standard efficiency 53%. Relative efficiency based on indicator thermal efficiency 70%. Volumetric efficiency 80%. Stroke to bore ratio 1.25. Suction condition 1 bar 27 degrees Celsius. Speed 2400 RPM. Power at the brake 75 kilowatt. So calculate the compression ratio, indicator thermal efficiency, brake thermal efficiency and the bore and the stroke of the engine. So diameter and the stroke length of the engine. So we are given it is a 4-stroke petrol engine. Air fuel ratio is 15.5. Calorific value 45,000 kilojoules per kilogram. Air standard efficiency is 53%, 0.53. Mechanical efficiency is 0.81, 81%. Relative efficiency is 0.7. Volumetric efficiency 0.8. L by D ratio 1.25. Inlet condition P1 equal to 1 bar. T1 equal to 27 degrees Celsius, which is 300 Kelvin. Speed equal to 2400 RPM. And the brake power equal to 75 kilowatts. So we calculate the compression ratio from the air standard efficiency. So, air standard efficiency is 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1. So, R equal to 1 by 1 minus eta A to the power 1 by gamma minus 1. So, 1 by 1 minus 0.53 to the power 1 by 1.4 minus 1 equal to 6.6. So, the compression ratio is 6.6. Then, the indicator thermal efficiency from the definition of relative efficiency and air standard efficiency. So, indicator thermal efficiency equal to air standard efficiency into relative efficiency, which is 0.53 into 0.7 equal to 0.371, which is 37.1%. And we calculate the indicated power. So, indicated power equal to brake power by the mechanical efficiency. So, 75 divided by 0.81 equal to 92.6 kilowatts. And we calculate the mass of the fuel from the indicated thermal efficiency. So, mass of the fuel equal to IP divided by indicated thermal efficiency into calorific value. So, 92.6 divided by 0.371. So, indicated thermal efficiency is 0.371 into 45,000, which is 5.55 in 10 power minus 3 kilograms per second. And mass of the air equal to MA equal to MF into air fuel ratio. So, 5.55 into 10 power minus 3 into 15.5 equal to 0.086 kilograms per second. Now, we calculate the brake thermal efficiency. So, brake thermal efficiency equal to BP, brake power divided by mass of the fuel into calorific value, which is 75 divided by 5.55 in 10 power minus 3 into 45,000 into 100 equal to 30%. Then, we calculate the density of the air for the intake conditions. Rho equal to P by RT. So, 100 divided by 0.287 into 300 equal to 1.16 kilograms per meter cube. And theoretical mass of the air, so from the definition of volumetric efficiency, theoretical mass of the air equal to MA by volumetric efficiency. So, 0.086 divided by 0.8 equal to 0.1075 kilograms per second. Then diameter and the stroke length. So, theoretical mass flow rate equal to rho into pi by 4 d square into L. So, pi by 4 d square L equal to volume, rho is the density into n by 120. So, speed divided by 120 for 4-stroke cycle engine and k is the number of cylinders. So, rho into pi by 4 d square and we are given L equal to 1.2 times of diameter. So, n by 120 into k. So, substituting all the numerical values, mass, theoretical mass equal to 0.1075 equal to 1.16 into pi by 4 d to the power 3 into 1.25 into 2400 divided by 120 into 1. So, left hand side is 0.1075, right hand side is 22.765 into d cube, diameter to the power 3. So, solving this equation, diameter equal to 0.168 meter, which is 16.8 centimeter, and the stroke length equal to 1.25 times of diameter, so which is 0.21 meter, which is 21 centimeter. So, the answer to the problem, compression ratio is 6.6, indicator thermal efficiency 37.1%, brake thermal efficiency 30%, bore and the stroke diameter equal to 16.8 centimeter and the stroke length equal to 21 centimeter. And we take the next problem from November 2014 question paper. Calculate the diameter length of the stroke of diesel engine working on 4-stroke constant pressure cycle from the following data. Indicated power 18.75 kilowatts, rotations per minute 220, compression ratio 14, fuel cutoff 1 by 20th of the stroke, index of expansion 1.3, index of compression 1.35, length by diameter, stroke length by diameter is 1.5, assume the pressure and temperature of the air at the inlet conditions are 1 bar and 40 degree Celsius respectively. So, we write down the given data. So, we are given indicator power 18.75 kilowatts, speed equal to 220 rpm, compression ratio equal to 14, cutoff equal to 1 by 20 of the stroke, index of expansion is 1.3, index of compression is 1.35, LBD ratio 1.5, P1 equal to 1 bar, T1 equal to 40 degree Celsius, which is 313 Kelvin. For isentropic compression process, we calculate the pressure and temperature. So, P2 equal to P1 into V1 by VC to the power NC, that is the compression ratio, polytropic index for the compression process. So, P1 into R to the power NC, which is 1 into 14 to the power 1.35 equal to 35.26 bar. T2 equal to T1 into V1 by V2 to the power NC minus 1. So, the NC is the polytropic index for the compression process. So, T1 into R to the power NC minus 1, which is 313 into 14 to the power 1.35 minus 1 equal to 788.3 Kelvin. Now, we take the, calculate the work done during the compression process. So, this is the 1 to 2 is the isentropic compression process. So, for the compression process, work compression equal to P2 V2 minus P1 V1 divided by NC minus 1. So, the numerator is R into T2 minus T1. So, R into T2 minus T1 divided by NC minus 1. So, substituting numerical values 0.287 into 788.3 minus 313 divided by 1.35 minus 1 equal to 381.55 kilojoules per kilogram. Now, we take the constant pressure heat addition process 2 to 3. So, for the 2 to 3 process, V3 minus V2, the cutoff volume is 1 by 20 times of the stroke volume V1 minus V2. So, left hand side, we take V2 outside. So, V3 by V2 minus 1 equal to 1 by 20 of V2 again outside. Here in the right hand side, V1 by V2 minus 1. So, V2 is getting cancelled. So, we have RC minus 1 equal to 1 by 20 of R minus 1. So, RC equal to 1 plus 1 by 20 of 14 minus 1 equal to 1.65. Now, the temperature T3 equal to T2 into V3 by V2, which is T2 into RC, which is 781.3 into 1.65, calculating 1300.7 Kelvin. Now, for the expansion process, T4 equal to T3 into V3 by V4 to the power polytropic index NE, polytropic index for the expansion process minus 1. So, this is T3 into RC by R. We know V3 by V4 equal to RC by R to the power NE minus 1. So, 1300.7 into 1.65 divided by 14 to the power 1.3 minus 1. So, index for expansion is 1.3. So, calculating 684.8 Kelvin. And the work done in the expansion. So, WE equal to P3 V3 minus P4 V4 divided by NE minus 1, which is R into T3 minus T4 divided by NE minus 1. So, 0.287 into 1300.7. minus 684.8 divided by 1.3 minus 1 equal to 587.3 kilojoules per kilogram. Now, the specific volume we calculate for the compression process, V1 equal to RT1 by P1, this is equal to 0.287 into 313 divided by 100 equal to 0.8983 meter cube per kilogram, and V2 from the compression ratio, V2 equal to V1 by V2, which is 0.8983 divided by 14 equal to 0.064 meter cube per kilogram. Then, work done in the constant pressure process. So this is M WCP constant pressure process P2 into V3 minus V2. We take P2 V2 into V3 by V2 minus 1. So this P2 V2 equal to R into T2 V2 by V3. V3 by V2 equal to RC. So RT2 minus into RC minus 1. So 0.287 into 788.3 into 1.65 minus 1 equal to 147.1 kilojoules per kilogram. And we take the PV diagram again. So the net to work done, indicated mean effective pressure equal to net to work done divided by the swept volume. What is net to work done? The expansion process 2 to 3, 3 to 4. So work done during the constant pressure process, expansion process minus work done for the compression process. That is the area of the net area of the PV diagram. So area of the PV diagram is the net to work output. So WCP minus plus WE minus WC divided by the swept volume V1 minus V2. So 147.1 plus 587.3 minus 381.55 equal to volume V1 0.8983 minus 0.064 equal to 422.93 kilopascal. So the indicated mean effective pressure is 422.93 kilopascal. Now calculate the stroke and the diameter. IP equal to indicator power equal to PIM pi by 4 d square into L into n by 120 into number of cylinders K. So calculate the substituting 18.75 equal to 422.93 into pi by 4 d square into 1.5 times of d. L equal to 1.5 times of d, 220 divided by 120. So 220 is the speed, 120 into single cylinder, number of cylinder equal to 1. So left hand side is 18.75. Right hand side is 913 d to the power 3. So solving diameter equal to 0.274 meter, which is 27.4 centimeter, and stroke length is 1.5 times of diameter. So 1.5 into 27.4 equal to 41.1 centimeter. So the diameter of the cylinder is 27.4 centimeter and the stroke length is 41.1 centimeter. So we stop here. So these are all the books I referred, so you can also refer to it. So there is one book written by me, so you can refer to it. There are other book available for the problem, you can refer to it for additional information. And these are all the books I published earlier. So design of transmission system, turbo machines, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, fluid mechanics and fluid machinery. And also I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures of the subjects mentioned here and the video lectures on the solution for the gate question paper. So it is absolutely free of cost. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning and pass in the gate examination. So thank you for watching. You please post your comments on the comments box of the YouTube video and you subscribe the channel and you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification. So thank you. We'll meet again in another video with additional problems in the IC engines.